Let's summon the Watcher. Necronomicon is coming. The Watcher is a spiritual protector that you summon whenever you do Necronomicon rituals, such as the gatewalking or any of the 50 name spells or any of the spells in the Maklu text or any of the spells in the Irelia text. The Watcher, from what I've read and from what I've come to understand, is actually not only a portion of your soul, but also can be kind of seen as a guardian angel. If you read the Book of the Watcher in the Necronomicon, the invocation talks about how no geometer has ever measured the being, nobody else has ever seen the being, and that is because this is your own personal guardian angel, in a way. Nobody else has seen or measured this being because it is yours, and no one else has seen it because only you can see it. The Watcher is used in the different spells in the Necronomicon to kind of carry out the spells and the works that you do, so it can be kind of thought of as a thought form or a fetch that you can use in your spells to gain certain ends. To summon the Watcher, you have to follow the book closely and do things in the right order with the right materials. For starters, you're going to need the Agamassaratu, which is the bowl of the Watcher where you make a sacrifice to the Watcher. In essence, sacrifices give a spirit or an entity energy to feed off of so they can manifest. In terms of the Agamassaratu and the offerings, you are to burn cedar incense, pine sandalwood or cedar, and the herb Olierbos, which from the research that I can tell would be stinging nettles. Like any other magical workings, sometimes the use of herbs or other substances can be used to kind of elevate yourself to be open up to more energy or supernatural beings or supernatural happenings. Olierbos is one of those. I've read that Olierbos or stinging nettle can kind of elicit a hallucinogenic effect at some levels, and this allows you to be opened up a little bit more. A little caution when it comes to using these different things in rituals. Some people will talk about using DMT. Some people will talk about using marijuana. Some people will talk about using like ritualistic tobacco or even alcohol at some points. And I guard against the use of these things because they can be habit forming, and using any type of thing that alters your perceptions can not only be habit forming, but it, if used to the higher amount, it can actually ground you more, which would lessen the effects of different spells and lessen your ability to perceive them. There are two invocations with the Watcher, and there is also the Sword of the Watcher. The invocations, there's the preliminary invocation, which is the first one that you do, and there is the normal invocation, which is the one that you do every time after that. When you make offerings to the Watcher in the Agamassaratu, you are supposed to do this monthly, and if you don't, when you are working with the Watcher, especially when going through the gatewalking, or if you have sent the Watcher off on a mission, they could go haywire and get very angry at you and might actually cause some paranormal activity in your home or any of the negative stuff that I've talked about before. So when making the Bowl of the Watcher, try to find something that is useful in burning the Olierbos and something that you can either etch on or draw on, because I like to kind of ramshackle things together. I know I mentioned this in a previous video, but my Agamassaratu is actually a salsa bowl from the dollar store, which you would think you can't really burn anything in, but that's why I put a rock in mine that I put the Olierbos on. And when I was reading the Papers in the Attic blog, you can kind of decorate it with different sigils and glyphs to kind of not only make it your own and make it personal to you, but also to empower the Bowl of the Watcher. On the outside of mine, I have the name and the power word for one of the 50 spirits, 50 names of Marduk. So I have Asarulludu and the power word Banmaskim, which would invoke the spirit or the name of Marduk when I use the bowl of the Watcher. I also put some Triforces on it just to kind of tie it to myself. That's the sigil for the spirit, the Asarulludu. And I also have the three signs. I have the Bandar, the Arasar, and the Elder Sign on it. And on the inside, I actually have several other sigils. I'm going to try to turn it without spilling anything. And I have Hylian lettering in it to also tie it to me to make it more personally mine. You could use brass or silver or even dollar store supplies to make your own Agamasaratu for use in Necronomicon rituals. The Sword of the Watcher, also known as the Dagger of Inanna, which is supposed to be made out of copper, is raised high in the air when you invoke the Watcher, whether you're doing the preliminary invocation or the normal invocation, and then you are to stab it in the ground where next to the bowl of the Watcher. If you do your spells indoors, like I do, then you could have a bowl of dirt to stab your Dagger of Inanna or the Sword of the Watcher into. At the end of the ritual, you are to touch the Sword of the Watcher, which is a sign that it is allowed to depart. For my Sword of the Watcher, I used to use my Athame, but I haven't completed making it yet because I still need to etch things on it, but I was gifted this copper dagger that I could use as the Sword of the Watcher. And now for some precautions about working with the Watcher. Like I said before, if you are going to work with the book and you are going to work with the Watcher, make sure that you follow all of the steps to the letter. Don't think that you can do the normal invocation of the Watcher before the preliminary invocation of the Watcher, because that could send some bad energy out and it could go haywire, and your Watcher that you haven't even met yet might do something negative to you. When it comes to making the offerings, you have to make them not too small, not too big. And really trust your intuition on this when you offer the Olieros or any other things that you might want to add in there. Because you don't want to have it too much, not only because the Watcher could use the energy and go a little bit haywire, but remember, there are always spirits around. There is always energy that could turn negative around, and it could feed off of the excess offering that you give, and it could cause some negative activity in your home. Remember that working with the Watcher kind of sets up a partnership. You have to make the monthly offerings to the Watcher when you are working with it, and I suggest that when you are done working with the Watcher, like if you are done with the gatewalking, at the last time you do an offering to the Watcher, you can state that you are suspending the partnership with the Watcher. When it comes to the monthly offerings, you're supposed to do those kinds of things along the calendar with 3 days before the full moon. If you happen to miss a day or something, you could even do it astrally in your mind, offering some Olieros to the Watcher, go into meditation, picture your Agamasaratu, put some Olieros on it and burn it. And because you are connected with the Watcher, they will see this as respectful. I would stick as much as I could to doing it the physical way, because anytime you do physical rituals rather than astral ones, they do tend to have some more of an effect, unless you're very, very, very skilled with meditation, astral travel, and things like that. The Watcher can be a very helpful spirit as long as you follow the rules. But don't be afraid of it, because remember, any time that you feed fear into ritual work or feed fear into anything, that fear will just grow stronger. You can't kill fear with fear. The first time that I saw the Watcher when I was working with the book, I didn't really get afraid. Like I said, the feeling that I had was a feeling of protection. I could be afraid of a shadow in the corner of my room, given my past experiences that I've talked about, but when you summon something with the intention of it helping you, don't be afraid of what comes up. That kind of goes along with any invocations that you do or any summoning that you do. If you are going to be afraid when you do it, then don't summon anything. Have faith in yourself, have the willpower to do it, and don't be scared. And like it says in the Necronomicon spellbook, good hunting.